Hey there, Lego fans, it's Jang here from JANGBRiCKS.com, and I'm very proud to be able to bring you this look at Benny's Spaceship! This is a 940-piece set.
Highly anticipated box was highly anticipated, and on the back of the box is the back of the box, but let's get to the real deal.
Behold the glory of a slowly rotating spaceship.
Spaceship!
It is finally in hand after months of anticipation. Straight out of the Lego movie, a one-to-one direct exact replica based exactly upon the models that were created to be rendered into the movie. Actually, there's one thing that ought to be changed here. Pop that up, little communication dish back there. I think this straight-on shot is really epic. It just looks so menacing right from the front. Move up a foot or so and you start to see some of its length and a little more of its mass. Now this is the view that I haven't seen before, directly from above. A very interesting profile with the striking straight canards up front, and then some very nice gentle angles going towards the back. You can see the tapered wings as well, and then a huge mass of engine outlets in the back.
How about the underside? Always a camera-shy view of LEGO sets, but it gives you a little bit of understanding of just how the whole thing is put together.
This thing has some pretty beautiful lines on it. It is clearly very heavily influenced and inspired by the classic space line. Obviously, you've got the LL929 there to kind of connect it with the LL918 to 924 and 928, the old sets that I have previously reviewed that launched the whole space theme from LEGO. Here we are getting a little closer into the front section so you can see how that's built. You can just guess what these are. Yep, they're flickfire missiles, four of them there. You can change the angles of the wing tips if you want to angle these down for a little more of a gull wing kind of look, or angle them up, or just keep them straight and flat. I think they're intended to be angled just ever so slightly up. This cockpit piece is huge. We'll go ahead and open that up. You see it's on a ratcheting joint, and towards the front you've got some lights that show up, as well as a couple of panels. Those are just two side-by-side printed slopes. You get seating for three individuals there, so Benny can be the pilot. You can get outer space wild style in there, and you can also fit the special Emmett. And because of the old style of pieces that they're using for the seats, you actually have enough room for the piece of resistance on his back. On the sides there, you'll also notice that there are stickers on these long tile pieces, and those stickers all represent reproductions of famous prints that were used on printed pieces for all of the old classic space sets. On the sides, you've got some inlets with the grating pieces with the arched window kind of frames. And then back here, you actually have space for one more passenger. That would be Astro Kitty, who's gonna fit right down in there. Slides in. She even has a little brace to hold her tail down. Now, I will show you all of the figures independently and up close later on, but for now, let's finish with the spaceship.
Spaceship!
While we're here, we've got one spring-loaded shooter on either side. So these are the ones that were introduced with the Star Wars line that just push that down and shoots out rather well. You get a total of three of these things, so if you lose one, you can still be fully loaded up. One of my favorite design features on this thing, strangely, is the use of these hoses. Just the way that they bend around, have a nice little bit of overlap there. It's just really, really nice. And these are the more recent style hoses that have the peg style ends at both ends. They're also very soft, so they bend around very nicely. Underneath all that, there's more to see. This opens to give you the interior compartment. This has a couple of tech stations, I would call them, with a couple more of those printed slope pieces. You've got a seat right here, and you could stand another figure back here, stand one or sit one back here. And behind all that is a reactor core. It's got a temperature gauge on it that is a clear panel piece with a clear backed sticker. And there is the reactor core itself.
Ooh.
Farther back, you have this interesting compartment here in kind of the mass core of the whole ship. This is where you get the communication dish that's able to fold down, or it can fold up. When it folds up, it reveals some texture and detailing in there that looks suspiciously like a couple of small little robots. That's because it is a couple of small little robots. You can actually pull those guys out and they will be able to stand up and you can kind of move their arms around. This is just another throwback to the classic LEGO space sets. Now the Emmett character in the LEGO movie may be the special and he may carry around the piece of resistance, but for this set, the true special feature that is its piece de resistance, I would say, is this. Yeah, that just happened. Let's just do that again. Here goes. Uh-huh. Let's check it out from another angle. Now from the back. Just like that. Not only does it look cool and feel cool to do that, but it also reveals these extra shooters on the sides. And these are these classic Technic pieces, which work really, really well. They shoot very large projectiles and they shoot long and straight. You just pull back. This is your trigger right over here. And I'm gonna try to keep this from going too far. Ow! Yeah, that has some power behind it. And as you saw, the mechanism is hidden in one of the engines, the center engine down here. When you push it in, that's what causes the whole thing to come out. It's really slick, it's smooth, it doesn't feel like it's catching on anything. It feels really well engineered in there. And I don't have any worries about this breaking down over time. Out at the wing tips, meanwhile, you've got an interesting thing going on here because this is a breakaway little scout ship that can be taken off. Fold this down, bring the other thing down, and yeah, that is something you can actually sit a figure in, complete with an engine. And you get two of them, one on either side. There's what that pair looks like. So these are kind of just little bonus ships, effectively, that you get. A little panel, control panel in there, a little bit of a heads-up display up on the top. I really like the engines. They just look really big, and you get little laser shooters in the front as well. This entire front section is able to lean forward, and then you can put in a figure who's gonna have to lean back. That's why they put that heads up display sticker up on what looks like the ceiling. It's really heads up. You have to look up with your head. You could also sit the figure up a little bit more like that, but I don't think that looks as good. This is another small extra ship included with the set. This is a Robo Police Interceptor. And this is the bad guy ship. Just one of what could be many. Just imagine swarming with these things. And I love what they've done with the Octan logo, kind of combining the Octan logo with a space logo kind of theme, just merging together two of the ultimate LEGO exclusive kind of made up brands into one. I love it. I like the choice of the Blacktron black kind of style there. But just a really sleek looking thing. Looks like it's very sci-fi, retro sci-fi though, and I love that. And yet it uses just modern pieces. This is really, really cool. This thing is a big surprise to me. I really didn't look at this, looking at pictures of the set long in advance of its release. And this one caught me by surprise. I genuinely love this little thing. The canopy opens up the whole thing, and I'll put the little robo policeman in here. Yes, there he is down in there with this red visor. All right, pretty cool. Let's go ahead and take a look at the minifigs now. Left to right, we've got everybody's favorite 1980-something space guy, Benny, followed by Space Chick Wild Style, followed by Emmett with the robot disguise, which doesn't really go with this set at all, but nice to get a new version of him. Astro Kitty, and then, oops, a Robo Police Pilot. Very cool face on that one too. And you'll see that Astro Kitty does have the space logo only on one side, and Emmett in this version has the silver colored piece of resistance, metallic silver, exclusive to this version. And there's what everybody looks like with all the extra stuff removed. So you do get secondary faces for Benny and Wild Style, extra silver printing around the back of Robo Emmett. And here's one last look at him from the front, completely unobstructed. Do I like the set? Of course I like the set. And we've had high quality photos out there of this set from every angle for months now. So there aren't many surprises here. The biggest surprises for me are how much I like the additional little bad guy things added on the side. I'm especially happy with how solid the build of the main spaceship is. This is just a really good thing. This is a very positive thing that LEGO has done here. It's really great just how much interest the community has gotten into this, including folks who weren't even really into Lego that much before after watching the Lego movie that really wanted to check out the spaceship. And of course it really has that connection to folks who were around during the days when classic space was originally out, all the sets that really inspired the creation of this one. I'm sure there are going to be a lot of adults out there who will buy this, both to relive a little bit of the classic feel, the nostalgia of the old classic space lines, and to try something new that connects with a recent movie. Of course, you're gonna see me do more with this thing. I did buy multiple sets for a reason. I'm gonna keep this one exactly like this. I'm not gonna take it apart. It will be displayed for a very long time. But for now, that's it for this video. I gotta cut it off. I've gotta go build some more stuff. Please leave a comment in the comment section, just letting me know what you think about this set in general, what about it you like, if there's anything about it that you don't like, what kind of feelings it brings back to you, if you have any nostalgia, if you were from the era of classic space, or if you weren't, then does this kind of motivate you to want to try out some of the older sets, or to encourage LEGO themselves to bring this whole theme back as an entire theme, not just for the LEGO movie. Thank you in advance for your feedback. Thank you again for watching this video, and stay tuned for more, because more videos are coming from me very, very soon.